What's the deal with humidity meters, or hygrometers as they're officially called? I have three of them here, and although they're displaying pretty close in terms of their temperatures, within a few degrees of each other, this one's stuck in Celsius for some reason, but 21.8 Celsius is about 71 degrees Fahrenheit, so they're pretty close in terms of temperature readings, but their humidity readings are all over the place. 35%, 57%, 46%, and they've all been sitting right next to each other for at least an hour. So you think they'd be reading the same thing. So what? Are they just guessing? But that's not what this video is going to be about. It's about this thing. A Palm IIIe handheld personal digital assistant from 1999. This was a thrift store find, as most of my things I show in my videos usually are. The first PDA was the Apple Newton, introduced in 1993. It was this huge brick-like thing, which didn't really work that well. It was expensive, and it was pretty much a commercial failure. The Palm Pilot, introduced in 1997, was the first really successful PDA. The Palm 3 series replaced it in 1998, but a lot of people still called it the Palm Pilot, even though it was not officially called that anymore. And this model, the Palm IIIe, was introduced in 1999. The original list price was $229. It has 2 megabytes of RAM, a 16 megahertz Motorola Dragon Ball EZ processor, which is actually based on the Motorola 68000 series. It has a 160 by 160 resolution 2-bit grayscale monochrome LCD, which is a touchscreen. It has a stylus. It can store 6,000 addresses, 5 years worth of appointments, 1,500 to-do items, 1,500 memos, and 200 emails. So you already saw the cover, which for some reason doesn't flip all the way around like most of them did, which is kind of stupid, but of course you can remove it pretty easily. On the back is the stylus, which we will need for operating it. There's the information sticker. It's made in Mexico. Runs on 2 AAA batteries. And the battery life of this thing is 2 months. And I've been using this thing for an entire week on these crappy Harbor Freight carbon zinc batteries. And the batteries are still almost totally full. So I do not doubt that this thing could last 2 months on a set of batteries. Here's the connector for syncing it with your computer. Also on the back is an infrared port for wireless data transfer to other Palm devices. That side is nothing. That side is a contrast wheel for the LCD. And we get some buttons on the bottom here. This is the power button. It turns on instantly. Don't you wish your smartphone or tablet turned on that quickly? There you can see how much battery life is remaining. So, it has the aforementioned address book, which already has some numbers in it for ordering accessories or technical support, which I'm sure is no longer valid because Palm got bought out by Hewlett Packard. So I don't think they really provide any support for these things anymore. But those are examples of some of the things you can store in the address book. Has a calculator, basic 4-function calculator. Does not have a square root, which is kind of surprising. But you can do your standard 4-function calculator operations on it. You can actually use it with your finger because the buttons are large enough. But most of the things on the screen are a little bit too small to use your finger. So that's why they give you the stylus. It has a date book, which you can store appointments. Like, for example, at 10 o'clock, I'll add a new entry. Start at 10 o'clock, end at 11. And this is where the handwriting recognition comes into play. Oops. V. Now the V is like that. I'm not an expert at this. I just practiced it a little bit. So There, I just entered record YouTube video through the handwriting recognition, which is known as graffiti. You can see it right there. And you use this part of the screen for entering letters and this part for entering numbers. It has a memo pad. I'll show you one of the entries I added here. This part I entered using the on-screen keyboard, and I switched back to the graffiti handwriting recognition. To get to the on-screen keyboard, you use this button, which brings you the pull-down menus. Go to Edit, Keyboard, and now you have an on-screen keyboard. So it's a bit of a toss-up as to whether you'd be faster using on-screen keyboard or the handwriting recognition. I guess it depends on how good you are at that graffiti handwriting recognition. Here's the to-do list, which already has something here. Fill out and return your registration card or register by phone or fax. But you wouldn't believe how many people still use fax machines these days. Special offers on accessories and add-ons. Sneak previews of new product enhancements and software releases. Because you can install software on these things, including games. This is running Palm OS 3.1. I know it says 3.0, but it's actually Palm OS 3.1. And the Palm 3e is a little bit different in that it does not have a flash ROM, so you cannot upgrade the OS version, unlike most other Palm PDAs. And you can set a password on this. You can turn off and lock device. So if you think locking your phone is something new, this thing had it in 1999. When you first set up one of these, you have to go through the welcome screen, which shows you how to remove the stylus and tap anywhere to continue. Then you have to tap it right in the middle of where they're telling you. Which calibrates it. Then you enter your time and date. Setup complete. They show you a tutorial on how to use the graffiti handwriting recognition. Try it. See there, they give you some examples of how the letters are drawn. And in case you're in a dark environment in which the screen doesn't show up that well, it does have a backlight. You just hold down the power button for a few seconds. And there it lights up. It shows up in inverse video, unlike the earlier Palm models, which some people didn't like this. Some people actually preferred it compared to the old version. So I noticed in some environments, it actually makes it worse when you turn on the backlight. Like right there, you can kind of see it's more visible without it. But of course, when it gets really dark, then it certainly does make a major improvement and your ability to use it. And this was going to be pretty much the end of the video until I found this at the thrift store today. It's the hot sink cable for the Palm 3 series. Paid $1.99 for it. Plugs into your serial port on your computer. That cable plugs into the connector on the bottom here. So let's try it out. While I'm booting up my ThinkPad, here's a size comparison of a modern smartphone. This is actually one of the smaller ones you can buy today. And its stupid screen keeps dimming because it has to conserve its battery life. Well, you can leave this thing on all day and it doesn't even matter. So, in terms of height, they're about the same. This is a little bit wider, a little bit thicker. But it still fits just fine in your shirt pocket. So here's my trusty ThinkPad T20, which I was thankfully able to recover from the Sony rootkit I installed in one of my previous videos. I just ran the official XCP uninstaller program. It seems to have taken care of it. And I was able to download and install Palm Desktop 4.1.4, which is the last version that can run in Windows 98. The last ever version of Palm Desktop is 6.2, I believe, which some people have even gotten to work in Windows 10. So that's running on the computer, and now I'm going to plug in the hot sink cable into the Palm turn it on. And now I should be able to just hit hot sync on this and do local sync. Connecting with the desktop. Don't know if I have it set up right. Okay, I think I found the problem. It's set to USB. I have to change it to local and make sure it's set to the serial port. Local COM 1. So let's try that again. There we go. I already created an account, so let's choose that. And there it goes. It's doing the update. To-do list, everything, synchronizing. And there's done. You now need to reset your handheld computer by tapping the button below. Huh, that's how fast it takes to boot up. And remember that thing I typed in using the handwriting recognition? It's right there on the computer now. So I'll add a new one here. Test of synchronizing data from computer to Palm. So now if I do another hot sync, okay, let's go to the date book, and there it is. The entry I created on the computer is now on the Palm. And I found a Tetris game for Palm OS. Don't know if it's going to work on this model, but I'll give it a shot. So we'll sync it to the Palm. So now I guess if I do a hot sync, it's going to install that. They're synchronizing Tetris. And let's see. Aha! There it is, Tetris. It installed. So let's try playing Tetris. Even has music. Press up to start. Okay. It's a limited demo. Try the demo. So how do we work this thing? Paused. Okay. Press up to resume. Okay, so you use the buttons rather than the touch screen. That's fair enough. That drops it. Alright, I think that moves it around. It's gonna take a while to get used to these buttons. Let's try to at least get one line completed. I don't know about that one. Gonna need some of those long ones to finish this row, which row is the hardest to get. But the next one is gonna be one of those. I like the different patterns they put on them. There we go. So that's Tetris for the Palm 3. I think it said copyright 2003. So, Tetris Classic by Handmark, version 1.22. Officially copyrighted by the Tetris Company, so it's an official Tetris. It's not one of those unofficial clones. So that's about it for the Palm 3e. Personal digital assistant from 1999. And look at that, I've been using it for pretty much an hour now to make this video, and the battery life is exactly where it was when we started. So probably not too many people use these things anymore, but certainly for quite a while, these were very handy things to have. before everybody started replacing them with Blackberries and then later iPhones. But you're certainly not going to get 2 months of battery life out of an iPhone.